Hello, Odooers. Today, we're going to use the CRM app. This acronym stands for Customer Relationship Management, and customer relationships are something we want to optimize at Stealthy Wood. As our company grows, it becomes more and more challenging to keep track of what needs to be done and where we're at with each customer. Imagine walking from one desk to another to stay up to date with your team's sales. Well, at Stealthy Wood, we no longer have to do that. From now on, all of our opportunities are neatly organized in our CRM pipeline. As a sales manager, it's best to identify the stages that are required to complete a deal and what actions you need to take at each stage. This way, the sales team knows exactly what to do at each stage of the pipeline and can efficiently pave the way for the next step, continuously moving the customer forward in the pipeline until the deal is won. This great tool also makes it easy and efficient to do weekly reviews by the sales manager with the team itself, allowing everyone to make sure that the pipeline keeps flowing flawlessly. So let's dive in to see how the CRM app helps Stealthy Wood be more efficient. All right, so let's go ahead and jump directly to the CRM application. Once we're here, we're going to see an overview of our own opportunities. And I know that because if I look at the search bar, I'm going to see this filter, My Pipeline. If I remove this, I will see all of the opportunities, which I have the access rights to see. Okay, so what I'm going to do straight away is simply create a new opportunity. So I'm going to click on the Create button. I'm going to create one on the fly. So let's go ahead and call this 200 lamps. Okay, I'm going to choose my customer. So I, again, can create a customer on the fly like I am doing for the opportunity, or I can choose one that already exists. So let's go ahead and select an already existing customer. And I'm going to add the expected revenue. So let's say $2,000. And since this is quite a bit of money, I'm going to make this a high priority. Then I'll click on Add. Now it's added right here in our column new, okay? And since I created the opportunity, I'm automatically going to be assigned to it, which is why I still see it, even though we have the My Pipeline filter added. All right, so it's in the new column now since it's just created, but actually I was talking to this customer and I have been able to qualify this opportunity. So I'm gonna go ahead and select it and drag it and drop it to the next stage, qualified. Now, something I want to point out here is that the expected revenue adds up for the entire column. Okay, so we know that this opportunity might be worth $2,000. So if I drag it and drop it and send it back to new, we're going to see that $2,000 is added to the $80,000 that the new column already had. So now it's $82,000. And that amount will follow for this opportunity to each column it goes to. And that expected revenue, that total expected revenue, will be at the top right here. Okay, so now this is qualified, but let's imagine now that we went ahead and created a quotation for this opportunity. Okay, so I'm going into the opportunity. You can create a new quotation right here. So let's imagine I went ahead and I did that. So I've given them an offer. I'm gonna move this now from the stage qualified to proposition. All right, I can also change the stage right here from within the opportunity. Now, when we're looking at the opportunity, we have some extra bits of information we can add as well. All right, of course, we can change the customer if we would like to, all of their information. We have the salesperson, again, that's me. And we have our sales team. Now, our sales team Europe is automatically added because that is the sales team that I'm a part of. Okay, if I wasn't assigned to any specific sales team, this field would remain empty. We can add an expecting closing date. We can change the priority. Okay, and we did this as well from the Kanban view. We can also add some tags. So let's imagine I'm contacting this person mostly by email. I'm gonna create a tag on the fly, email. Okay, so right now there's no color on this tag, which means that it will not be visible in the Kanban view. You will, of course, be able to see it from within the opportunity, just not from the Kanban view. So if you do want to see it from that view, you simply have to click on the tag and add a color, any color you would like. So let's go ahead and choose orange or this kind of red color here. Okay, and we have that tag. As easy as that. All right, we also have company, we can add some notes, and we have some other follow-up information that we can add as well. Okay, So now, let's imagine the customer came back to me and they said, wow, this is a really great offer, so great, in fact, that I would like to double my order. Instead of 200 lamps, I actually would like to purchase 400. So while we're in the edit mode, let's go ahead and edit this quickly. Okay, so 400 lamps. Of course, we're going to double the expected revenue, and then we can save. But you know, I want people to know, or I want to know for myself, that this is a second proposition that I'm going to be offering them. Okay, maybe I would give them even a larger discount since they're purchasing even more lamps. But in any case, this is a second proposition. So I'm going to make a new column, a new stage just for that. So let's go back to the pipeline. And all we have to do is click on add a column. Okay, I'm going to call this a second proposition, easy enough. Okay, and then we're going to add, and I'm going to drag it and drop it where I would like to position this stage. Okay, so I'm going to put it between proposition and one. Okay, and I can even edit this stage by clicking on the little settings button here, clicking on edit stage. I can decide if this is a one stage. Okay, I can see if it should always be folded in the pipeline, and I can also assign this column to a specific sales team. So let's say it's only relevant to our sales team Europe. I can select that right here, so it will only be visible for them. I can also add some extra requirements right here if I would like to. So let's go ahead and save it the way it is now. And we're gonna drag and drop just like that. Okay, so let's go into that opportunity. There's something else important here that I would like to point out. So with each stage, your probability will be updated. So here I have $4,000 at 99.93%. If I change the stage, this will change automatically. Okay, so Odoo will automatically compute the probability you have to win a deal based on your past data. Okay, so the more we feed our database with opportunities that are won or lost, the more accurate this prediction will become. So if I win a deal, I won't have the same probability for the other ones, and it's constantly evolving based on the previous deals that I've won or lost. Okay, so if I click on edit, I can always change this myself if I would like to, or I can use what Odoo has given me. Okay, so if I go back to edit, I changed it as we just saw. I can always go back to what Odoo has estimated by clicking right here. Okay, so we're gonna go to save. Then we're gonna go to configuration and settings. And from the settings page, we're going to be able to see what Odoo uses to predict this score. Okay, we have predictive lead scoring right here. Okay, and we have these fields that are used in the probability computation. Okay, so we can add things, we can remove things. So let's go ahead and select here. Let's say perhaps I would like language to be added and not phone quality. So I can remove that. And then we'll click on save. Now I'm not gonna click on save right now because I would like this to go as fast as possible. I don't wanna bore my audience, but we're gonna go back to our CRM dashboard. Okay, I will not save the changes. And what I'm going to show you now is probably the best thing for any salesperson. I'm going to show you how you can win the deal by clicking on Marcus 1. As simple as that, then you have a beautiful banner that says 1. Okay, but let's imagine in the worst case scenario, this was actually lost. We can also mark as lost. And when we do that, we can provide a lost reason. And it's always important to keep track of why we're losing deals so we can prevent it from happening in the future. All right, it's good for your managers, it's good for your salespeople, and just to keep track of what's going on. So let's say that in the end, we didn't have the people or the skills to provide the customer with 400 lamps. So I'll just select this and then click on submit. Of course, the banner changes from one, it goes to loss, which is a bit upsetting, but it can happen to the best of us. So now that we've seen how to do this, I'm going to show you one more thing, our CRM reports. So we can click on reporting right here. We can go to pipeline or even activities, and we're going to see all kinds of information. You can also see it in different views. Now, I don't have any data yet to display. But if I remove some of these filters, maybe I will. So I'm going to remove create in the last 365 days. And we're going to see all of our opportunities. Now, I'm using demo data here, and of course, this will change based on the data you input in your database. But again, we have different views, so then we can change our measures and also how we group the information. Okay, so let's go ahead and say I would like to measure this based on probability. Okay, and I can group by different things. So right now, a few things are already selected, so I'll go ahead and remove that. Okay, and let's say I just want to group by country. I select country, I see all of my countries right here, and I can group by as many things as I would like. So let's go ahead and say email, job position, and I have all of this information. Okay, and of course we can do this for different graphs as well. So I can also change the measures right here. Okay, so it's just a really great way to keep track of what's going on and with your sales or with your sales team. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. And if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.